Hi Pisces, welcome to my channel. So today I am doing your upcoming weekly tarot reading. This will be for roughly December 7th to the 13th. Now I say roughly because time is fluid. What is important for my readings is that they resonate. And if they do, please trust that it is for you. All right, this is for my Pisces, December 7th through the 13th. Let's see what's happening for you this week. Let's give these a few more shuffles. Hangman, your own energy came out. All right, let's give these a few more and see what's happening. All right, let's stop here. The situation for you this week, challenging you. All right, where's your mind at? Your approach, any external influences or people that may be affecting you, and then the near future, what is coming towards you. Oof. All right, Pisces, you reached the end of the line here, the end of a journey here, and it's hard for you. It's hard. There's some chapter here that's got to close out. That's the situation this week with the world. It's like you've learned everything, lessons learned here. It's time to close this door and open up a new one and begin a new journey for yourself, a new chapter for yourself. In the challenge position, we have your energy again with the moon. The moon is the heaviest energy, right? It's the dark night of the soul. Like if you look at the card, see this creature coming out of the water. The water's to represent your subconscious. And the, you know, creatures are coming to the surface, your fears, your worst worries, your worst anxieties, you know? And that's what this closing of this door is doing. It's just, it's like what comes after this, right? It's kind of scary. The moon doesn't shine bright. It's not like the sun, meaning the path ahead you cannot see, and that's why it can be a bit scary. It's the unknown that's a little scary here. And while the moon comes up, it's here to teach us that things are not as they appear. Not everything is what it seems. All right. Your mind's focused on some sadness here with this chapter. It's like sad. What was lost? How it turned out? We're going to go in and clarify. We'll understand it better. Your approach is the Six of Swords. This is you saying you're in a state of transition. It's with a heavy heart, but like at this point, you know it's in your best interest to kind of move to a different place. Just to move on, right? Definitely moving away as well, because the emotional waters have been too choppy. And at this point, like I said, you know, like you have the mental strength to say, I know this is hard, but this is really what's best. It's time to move on to calmer waters. In your environment, you're at a crossroads. You're just like, it's feeling a little stuck right now, for sure, because of this moon energy, but just like, it's like this fork in the road. We gotta choose between two different paths here. Coming towards you is the Queen of Wands, great energy, taking the lead in a situation, being in touch with your spirituality. I love it, having a cooling effect if things are heated. All right, let's see, tell me more about the world. This chapter here for Pisces, that's just, you learned everything you needed to learn. You've gained everything you needed to gain. You passed the lessons, you passed the tests. That's what it is. It's like, it's graduation day. But it hurts for some reason because there's something in your heart that was lost here. Maybe relationships with those cups. All right, tell me about the world. And if not lost, it's just, it didn't turn out the way you'd hoped. And right now there is a sadness to it. All right, what's this world about for Pisces? December 7th to the 13th. Let's stop here. Yeah, Three of Cups is at the bottom. Yeah. Three of Cups is at the bottom, Pisces. On your mind, there are three cups spilled over. Definitely can be actually three things here for some of you. I don't know why. That's very particular. But certainly this is people in your tribe. All right. Ace of Swords, Ten of Cups. Woohoo! Yeah, people in your tribe. Yeah. It's clear to you. It's clear to you. Even though it's clear to you, it's bringing out the moon energy. It's, you know, if it's not becoming clear, then it's because of this moon. But clarity is here. It's, you know, that this relationship, there is a relationship with this Ten of Cups. This is not a career reading right now. There is and Ten of Cups is like, can be family, really. It's just one of the most important relationships in your life. And you know, you're at the end of the journey. That chapter is done. And you're honest about it with the Ace of Swords. With yourself, you're truthful, you're clear at this point. If you haven't been clear before, it's getting clear now. The moon is in the challenge position, though this is hard. It's hard for you to like acknowledge, right? Not acknowledge, but like, it's hard. It hurts, right? Like, you didn't want it to turn out this way. That's what I mean. All right, tell me more about the moon in the challenge position. Yeah, dark night of the soul is so hard. Because you're like, where do we go now? What's next? It's like trusting the unknown, right? Needing the faith and the trust again. All right, let's take you, Queen of Wands, and Nine of Pentacles. Whew. Yeah, you're going independent from... It's just whatever it is, you're going independent from a relationship. This, the chapter here has closed, and it's just, it's hard for you. It's hard for you. Because going single like that, independent like that from it, solo, maybe it's been a big part of your identity, a big part of your life, and it's just, it's hard to do that. It's like losing a part of yourself. Losing a part of yourself, and that's why it's like hard here with that Five of Cups. Let's see. Tell us more about the Five of Cups for where your mind is at. Yeah, the moon. Ugh. The moon will pass. And like I said, the lesson of the moon is that things weren't as they appeared. Like some of our worst fears were just that. They were in our head. And some weren't. I know. All right, tell me more about the Five of Cups for Pisces with where your mind is at December 7th through the 13th. Yeah, but it's a chapter here. Because the reason the chapter is over, Pisces, as well, is because, you know, when we don't learn our lessons, the universe is going to repeat the test. And then sometimes people will be like, why does this keep happening to me? And I always just want to be like, because you're not learning the lesson. So it's happening as a favor, right? But with the world being here is you've learned. It's like you're good to go. There's no more growth at that place right now. It's just that simple. There's nowhere for your soul to grow anymore. So that's why it's like the end of this journey. It's not saying the end of the end, but it is the end of that journey. All right, tell me more about this Five of Cups. But yeah, Pisces, graduation day, spiritual graduation day. Don't worry, new challenges are coming. This is the fool's journey. As promising as it is, it's always challenges. All right. Otherwise, how do we grow? Let's be honest. It's never in the light. Like, it's just not. All right. Let's do one more and we're going to stop here. Clarifying this Five of Cups. Yeah, Ten of Wands is at the bottom. It's oppressive. Is this weight, this sadness is holding you down. All right. The Lovers. Ace of Cups. Whoa. All right. The Lovers. For some of you, like, really, this could have been like an actual soulmate partnership. And it's just sad because things did not turn out how you'd hoped. And like on your mind, you're like, I need love to flow here. My self-love is really important here. So it's like a combination. It's like you're thinking about the love of yourself and the love within some relationship here. And let me say, if it's not about like an actual lover here, the Lovers is ultimately a card about a personal choice. It's a big choice. And I can see that you got a decision here. You got to change paths. This choice is about following your heart. But with the Lovers, usually it's a choice that like puts to test your personal beliefs. And so that choice is difficult, but it's on your mind. And you're like, I need to follow my heart. With that Ace of Cups, like I said, as hard as it is, you're like, I have to follow my heart. That's what the Lovers is. So I see you. You're standing before this crossroads, Pisces. Your approach is that Six of Swords. Moving on. And just like the characters in this card, you see how like their backs are hunched over? You don't do so with excitement. Like I said, you didn't want to, but it's like you just know that's where you're at now. It's, you just know what's best for not just yourself, for the situation, for others involved. All right, tell me more about the Six of Swords. No. In your approach. So many cards want to jump out. Like I saw the Fool for a moment. All right, two more. We're going to stop here. Yeah, Judgment is at the bottom. Big decision, yeah. It's standing before the crossroads here, Pisces, and you're like, I need to follow my heart, as scary as it is. Eight of Swords, King of Cups. Ugh. You're getting away from feeling powerless in a situation. If it's not powerless, there's something within your circumstances here with this Eight of Swords that you felt like was interfering with your progress. Couldn't see a clear solution. You couldn't see a clear way out. And now you're like mentally you're in a much stronger place. You're in a state of transition from that. You're literally moving away from that stuck energy. And you've got the King of Cups energy, embracing your own element here with water. This is you really mastering your emotions. That's where you're going from this place of feeling powerless, especially if it comes to your emotions, especially if it comes to your circumstances. And now you're in this place of mastering your emotions. You're like, I'm going to take control of my emotions. They are not going to get the best of me. In your environment, the environment, that's the crossroads here. And definitely can be with family. All right. The environment. Tell me about this Two of Swords. Yeah. I mean, crossroads screaming all over the place. What did fall out? Give me a moment. Oh, thank God I stretch. Oh, okay. Three of Wands is here. The moon. Okay. Oof. Double moon energy, Pisces. I feel for you this week. Okay. Yeah, the moon is making you feel stuck. It's the energy of the moon. You'll get through it. But it could be heavy. Three of Wands. You ready? You're starting to think. You're starting to think, Pisces. I feel like you've already had plans in your mind, and now you're starting to be like, okay, let me gather my resources. What do I need to put these plans into action? Definitely. You might be waiting while you navigate this energy. And the Three of Wands is like, this is even you ready. You're stepping out of your comfort zone. You're standing at a high vantage point here. But the moon energy might not be allowing you to see all that is possible for you. And all the challenges you may face as well. The journey comes with both. It's supposed to. But yeah, that moon, getting in the way, huh? Maybe not allowing you to see what is right in front of you. That's what the moon can do. Coming towards you, Queen of Wands. Taking the lead, connected to your spirituality. You know, very cool energy, very confident. Tell me about the Queen of Wands coming towards you. Can absolutely be a fire sign as well. King of Swords, we got an air sign. And death. Woo. Woo. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, so many people here. Can be a Scorpio. Can be an air sign. Can be a fire sign. It can be so many people here. But yeah, this is you. I mean, you're having the mental strength and strategy and the spiritual strength here. Mental and spiritual strength to face death. This is death of the ego. Letting old way goes. Letting old ways go for new ways to come in. Outdated versions of yourself. Outdated habits. They gotta go. Even though death can be really uncomfortable, people always beg to be spared. But make no mistake, it is not death, it is rebirth. It is rebirth. And that's what's coming to you. Goodbye to the old me, hello to the new me. Not just yet, because I see we're navigating the energy, but yeah, change is here. It's on the forefront. And I think you're starting to get excited about it, even if it's out of your comfort zone here, Pisces. All right, I'll leave it there for you. I really hope you enjoyed this reading, Pisces. If you did, please like and subscribe. As always, thank you so much for letting me tune into your energies, and I'll see you all next week.